Hello, good morning. Welcome back to the presentation on mechanics of materials. This is module 5, and this is the last lecture in this module 5, lecture 4. This is an initiative by VTU eSikshana program. In the previous lectures, we solved some problems, very important problems on columns, and we designed for the column for its diameter under the safe load using the Euler's equation and Rankine series. Today, we'll conclude this chapter by solving some very important problems. Let us see this problem. A hollow circular column is used to carry a weight of 200 kg through a height of 3 meters. It has a yield stress of the material of column as 330 megapascal. The column end conditions are, it is fixed at one end and free at the other end. Taking the Young's modulus as 200 gigapascal for the material of which the column is made. Then yield stress material spread and putting into newton meter square of the outside diameter is 100 meter is 5 meter. That is the length plus 72 into 6. 72 is the depth, thickness is 6 into 36 is the depth. Similarly, 60 into 6 plus 70 into 6. We'll get the value of the y bar, the distance of the centroid along the y-axis. Now, we can find the Ixx value by this equation, 60 into 6 cubed by 12 plus 60 into 6. Here, we have to subtract the value 53.7 from 75, the overall length. And also plus 6 into 72 cubed by 12 plus 6 into 72 into 53.73 minus 36. So this will get you the value of moment of inertia along the x-axis. Along the y-axis, it is easy because we have only one section symmetrical here. So that is 6 into 60 cubed by 12 plus 72 into 6 cubed by 12. So both the values, when you compare Ixx and Iyy, so the value of Iyy is less than Ixx. So hence, the value of Iyy is considered in the design of the load. Substituting the value here, pi square EI by LE square, we'll get the load as 56.5. So crippling load according for rectangular section is 13.83, and for T section it is 56.5. If you take the ratio, then it is 4.1. So that means the crippling load for T section is 4 times greater than the crippling load for the rectangular section. So this is an important problem. So like that, they can ask different problems on different types of sections. So coming to another important problem, a 1.5 meters long column has a circular cross section with a diameter of 50 mm. And then one end of the column is fixed and other end is free. This is the end condition. Taking factor of safety as 3. Calculate the safe load using Rankine's formula when the yield stress is 560 Newton per millimeter square and the Rankine's constant is 1 by 1600. That is one part. Second, find the safe load using Euler's formula for which Young's modulus is 1.2 into 10 to the power 6 Newton per mm square. So that means in this problem, you can find the safe load by both the Rankine's formula as well as Euler's formula. So first let us write the given conditions here. Length is given, diameter is given, factor of safety is given, then the stress is given, yield stress 560, Rankine constant is given, Young's modulus for the material is given. So first let us find the area of the circular cross section, pi by 4 d square, you will get the area. Then effective length for one end fixed, other end free is twice the actual length, so you'll get 3000 millimeters. Then from that you can find the, since it is a solid circular section, I is equal to pi by 64 d4, so you'll get the value of moment of inertia. Now we need k value here, radius of gyration, which is equal to square root of I by A. So if you substitute values, you'll get the k value is 12.5. Now let us find the first Rankine's crippling load, which is sigma c into A by 1 plus alpha into Le by k whole square. Sigma c is 560, area is 1963 plus 1 by 1600, 3000 by 12.5 whole square. So we'll get the crippling load as 29.72 kilonewtons. Okay. Now, we can, since the factor of safety is given, we can find the safe load by dividing the crippling load 29.72 kilonewtons by 3, that is 9.9 kilonewtons. So according to Rankine's theory, crippling load is 9.9 kilonewtons. According to Euler's, we have equation PCR equal to pi square EI by LE square. We can substitute the value of E, then moment of inertia, then effective length. We will get the crippling load as 40.37. The safe load we can calculate by dividing by factor of safety, you'll get 13.45. So according to Rankine's formula, crippling load is 9.9, and according to Euler's crippling load, the safe load is 13.45. Let us look into one more important problem here. It is a simple rectangular section of 300 breadth and 200 depth. It is now a rectangular section, x-axis and y-axis you can see. A rectangular column section 200 by 300 is 5 meters long with one end fixed, another end is free. Young's modulus for the material of which the column is made is 17.5 into 10 to the power of 3 Newton per mm square. Determine the crippling load and safe load, a factor of safety is 2.5. So here in this problem, we are using only, you can use the equation, that is Euler's equation, to find the crippling load. So first let us find the moment of inertia. Area is given already. So IXX along the x-axis, it is BD cube by 12, 200 into 300 cube by 12. Then along the y-axis, DB cube by 12, then 300 into 200 cube by 12. You will get the moment of inertia about x-axis and y-axis. Since the value of moment of inertia along y-axis is less than x-axis, the least value is considered. Effective length is 2L, twice the actual length, that is 10,000 mm. So equation, Euler's crippling load equation, pi square EI by L square. So here, remember you have to take the effective length, that is 10,000, substituting other values. So we'll get the value of crippling load as 345 kilonewtons. The factor of safety is given. We can divide to get the Euler's safe load, that is 138.2 kilonewtons. So this is a simple problem, but you need to find the values of moment of inertia. If area is not given, you have to find the area. And then according to end condition, you have to take the effective length. Next. I section. Similarly, I section is symmetrical about both y-axis and x-axis, then it will be easy to solve the problem. So let us read the problem. Determine the Euler's crippling load for an I section column 400, 200, 100. So 400 is the total depth, 200 is the total breadth, and 10 mm is the width of the web or thickness of the web. And 10 meters long with both ends hinged. The conditions you have to carefully note here. The Young's modulus for the material is given as 2.1 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per mm square. Let us find first IXX and IYY. Easy to find. So IXX is equal to 200 into 400 cube by 12 minus 190 into 380 cube by 12. So total we can take, total is 200 into 400. Out of that we can subtract the remaining, that is 400 minus 1010, that is 380. And this is 190. So if you subtract total, you'll get the IXS moment of inertia along x-axis. Then similarly, moment of inertia along y-axis, 10 into dB cube, 10 into 200 cube by 12, 10 into 200 cube by 12, plus 380 into 10 cube by 12, plus 10 into 200 cube by 12. So you'll get both the values. Again, you compare. The least moment of inertia is to be considered. So IYY is less than IXX. So we'll take the value of IYY. The effective length is same when both the ends are hinged, that is equal to actual length. So write the equation. US clipping load, PCR is equal to pi square EI by LA square. So pi square into 2.1 into 10 to the power of 5, Young's modulus, I is 1336.5 into 10 to the power of 4. And effective length is 1000 square, you will get the crippling load as 263814.5 newtons or 263.8 kilonewtons. So this is the problem which you can solve when, which is symmetrical about the axis. Next, coming to next problem, design a circular cast iron column to carry a load of 1000 kilonewtons. If one end is, let me see, one end of the column is fixed and the other end is free. So take the length as 6 meters. Factor of safety 3 and the Rankine's constant as alpha is equal to 1 by 1600. And the failure stress or critical stress can be taken as 560 MPa. First, we'll write the given values. Safe load given as 1000 kilonewtons. Let me just take the option here. Okay, safe load is 1000 kilonewtons or 1 into 10 to the power of 6 newtons. And then you have Rankine's constant, alpha, factor of safety, then the critical stress, and also the actual length. Now let us take the first safe load for the factor of safety given as 3. So PCR by FOS will get 3 into 10 to the power of 6 newtons. Area for solid circular cylinder. So since we need to design, find the diameter, let us keep the value in terms of D only. And then I is equal to pi D 4 by 64 for solid circular cylinder. Again, diameter is unknown. Keep the value in terms of D only. Then moment of the radius of gyration, K is equal to I by way. Substitute the values, you will get the value in terms of D only. Next is effective length is equal to twice the length, actual length, because one end is fixed, other end is free. Then you will get 12,000 millimeters. Use the crippling load equation, PCR equal to sigma C into A by 1 plus alpha into L by K whole square. Substitute the values. Then the value which is in terms of D, we can solve for this, that is 321.2 millimeters. You can round off the value. So here design means you have to find the diameter of the circular column. Coming to one more last problem, So determine the, it's an important problem here, determine the ratio of buckling strength of solid and hollow columns made of same material, having same length and cross-section area and other end conditions. Take internal diameter of hollow section as half the external diameter. Okay, we need to find the ratio of the buckling strength for two columns, that is solid and hollow. Both are made up of same material, having same length, cross-section area, and end condition. Whereas for hollow section, internal diameter is half the external diameter. So this is given here, d is equal to the diameter of the solid column, do is outside diameter, so where di is half do, then Young's modulus are same for solid and hollow, and the length is same for solid and hollow, area is also same, given conditions. Now, we need to take the crippling load and for the solid and hollow section. So now, since cross-section areas are equal, so area of solid cylinder is pi by 4d square, and area of hollow is pi by 4 do square minus di square. Di is half do. So if you take this, you will get d as 0.866 do. Then taking the crippling load equation, pi square ei by L square. Now you can take the ratio of hollow by critical. So write the ratio is PCR for hollow by PCR for solid, which is equal to, other things get cancelled here, pi square, Young's modulus, L gets cancelled, only moment of inertia remains here. So IH divided by IS actually here. Moment of inertia for hollow by moment of inertia for solid. Substituting this, pi by 64, moment of inertia of hollow, DO 4 minus DI 4, and for solid, pi by 4, D square. In place of DI, I will substitute half DO square to the power 4, that is 0.5 DO to the power 4. Then I'll get the ratio as 1.667. So that means the ratio of buckling strength of hollow column to the buckling strength of the solid column is 1.667. So that completes the problems on columns. Important, solved many problems in this lecture. So this completes the lecture on the module 5, that is columns. Thank you.